Using karambit for cutting an apple. How awesome will it be, huh?
It is actually cool, man. Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. This video is all about one of the most inquired questions. Knife laws are okay, but do they apply to karambits? Well, let's find out. First of all, a little intro about this knife. The karambit, also known as karambit, karambik, karambiak. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. Anyway, this knife has a ring at one end of the handle and a curved blade at the other. The ring is basically used to put your index finger in or your little finger in, depending upon the gripping style. It is derived from the shape of a claw of a tiger and hence another name, claw knife. These are way old. Like, karambits were originally native to Indonesia and were initially used back in the 11th century for cutting meat and for combat. Then according to folklore, they were weaponized by the Minangkabau people of Sumatra. It was hard to memorize. Then the weaponization spread across Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar and Philippines. Whew. Enough of the history lesson. Let's understand the different types of karambits. Now there are n number of karambits, like literally thousands of styles.
Use Google.
But we are looking into the legality part of karambits, so I'll be classifying karambits on the basis of their different sizes and types of blades available, which make them either outright illegal to possess or prohibited to carry depending upon its lethal nature. Firstly, the different sizes. Generally, all available karambits that are available in the market or on online platforms, they lie in the sweet range of 6.5 to 7.5 inches overall length. Now that's not a rule of thumb and sizes can greatly vary from manufacturer to manufacturer. If you saw my video explaining the general knife laws in India, you will remember point one, which is the length of the knife. And if you didn't, well, check out the video in the info card. So on the whole, if the overall length of the knife matches the length requirement of less than equal to 9 inches by 2 inches, then there shouldn't be any problem in owning that karambit. However, the question of carrying it with you in public, that is something to discuss. Now the point number 4 mentioned in my video clearly states the point of intent of carrying a knife. The knife laws in India being so vague and broadly classified do not really focus that much on the million types of knives available in the world, which is why your intent of carrying the knife really matters. Karambits are slowly gaining popularity in India and they are mainly either too fancy or maybe even deadly in appearance, which is why if you're ever found carrying a karambit in public, then definitely any law enforcement official can basically question you as to why you are carrying that knife, and the explanation of self-defense won't really work in your favor because there can be just one counter question like, why aren't you carrying something low profile like a pocket knife or maybe a simple looking fixed blade knife or anything else for self-defense. This knife is so deadly that it can cause fatal injuries to the other person and you can be booked for manslaughter. I'm pretty sure it'll be really hard to answer that. Now the hooked blade of the karambit, which is generally single-edged, the edge is on the inside. It is also available in the double-edged version, which is practically more lethal as you can not only cut from the inside of the hook, but from the outside as well. And many countries have openly declared them as illegal because of their sheer lethal nature. There's a long list of such countries, please Google it. But that is the main thing. Those countries have clearly mentioned in their laws that double-edged karambits are illegal. But I couldn't find any such thing for India from my research. So it may technically be legal in my opinion, but, and that's a strong but, I would suggest and as well recommend you to carry as less of a lethal knife as possible when out in public. Even with a karambit training knife, which is like not at all sharp and it just has a blunt hooked metal piece or rubber in front of it, in front of the handle, you can do some devastating damage to the opponent by different chokes and holds. Comment down if you want to see some karambit skills as well. But as you can clearly head online and purchase a real karambit knife, so they are definitely not illegal to own. Otherwise they wouldn't be available online openly at all. Makes sense, doesn't it? You can keep it at home, practice with some good training knives so that you don't cut yourselves, of course. make videos or whatever, just don't go overboard with the public display. Be smart, people. Alright, I hope I could clear the minds of all of you who either wish to purchase or have already purchased a karambit but were not sure about how legal it is in our country. Please keep in mind all the points that I've mentioned in this video and also do your own research, because if your intention behind keeping a knife is justified, logical and meets all the criteria that I've mentioned not only in this video but the previous video as well, then there shouldn't be any problem in owning a karambit knife. So there you have it. Do leave your comments down if you have a suggestion or a correction. I always appreciate and also respond to such constructive comments. Also, leave a like and help me spread awareness about the importance of having self-defense skills and debunk all the misconceptions about knives and some lesser known stuff in India by sharing it with your knife loving community and brethren. For more cool self-defense skills, information and some general life stuff, do make sure to subscribe to The Prowess Care.